What's up, all? It's Assist Shay Says, and welcome back. Today, we're speaking to Skye Townsend. She's an actress and comedian starring in the HBO hit comedy series, A Black Lady Sketch Show. For those who live under a rock, A Black Lady Sketch Show features hilarious comedy sketches performed by its core cast of Black women. The series also features celebrity guests like Issa Rae, Gabrielle Union, Amber Riley, and more. The show recently aired its second season in April, and I'm excited to speak to Skye about her experience. Hi, Skye. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Happy Friday. You look so beautiful.
Thank you. I'm in my house in my little setup, ready for a new episode tonight. So it's a Friday. Nice. It's a good day.
Nice. So I want to talk to you about your experience on A Black Lady Sketch Show. What was your favorite part about the experience?
Wow. Well, this season I play 25 different people. And yes. So I think the exciting part was, you know, you see the scripts and you imagine how you want to say the characters, but when you really get into hair, wardrobe, and makeup, and you start to see it coming alive, it's fascinating to see all of the moving parts connect. So I think that's the best part.
Yeah, and you mentioned that you played 25 characters in one season, which is a lot because, girl, like, different personalities. I don't know, like, how you were able to keep up and just do your thing. Like, you did an amazing job.
Yeah, so drastically different, too, you know? I mean, I play all types of characters that have just different quirks or they stand different. So you have to remember who moves like what. Yeah. And so I had a checkboard of like, remember, she has a shaky hand. She has tight shoulders. He moves like this. She talks like this. So you really have to just check all the boxes in the morning and then dive right into it.
Yeah, so I want to know, what was your favorite sketch to film?
Oh, in the opening episode, I play a character that a lot of people don't realize is me, so it's my favorite. But her name is Marquita, and she's an environmentalist who's really passionate about saving the world. Okay. And her voice, I mean, I look like Charlize Theron in Monster. Like, it's terrifying. My bangs are up to here. I'm covered in freckles and bleach blonde eyebrows. But that character was definitely the most fun to play.
Oh, that's so cute. So working with, like, a Black, beautiful cast of women, honestly, what are some life lessons that you've learned and you're continuing to take throughout your career? Because I'm sure, like, you have learned a lot within your experience and, you know, I'm sure there's a tons of lessons, but what are some that you would love to share with us?
Wow. The first one is, if you're early, you're on time. If you're on time, you're late. And if you're late, you're disrespectful. So that's number one.
Yes.
Number two, you know, something that my boss, Robin Thede, says a lot is that being tired is just temporary, right? Mm-hmm. In the moment we're creating and we might be exhausted, it might be 1 a.m. and we're filming, but she goes, you don't want to be upset with yourself that you didn't go harder when you watch the work. So I know you're tired, but being tired is just temporary. And that has stuck with me forever.
Oh my gosh, that is amazing, honestly. When I'm tired, I'm gonna wake myself up and keep it pushing because you just, you know, you never know. And you always feel sad when you know that you had that energy in you, but you didn't give it your all, for sure.
100%. Yeah. You
got to
go your hardest, always.
Yes. So your dad is Robert Townsend, and obviously he's a very popular filmmaker. What are some advice, or do you even go to him for advice, actually, for your career? Because I'm sure, like, you may want to hear from him, but then there's, like, sometimes you tend to get more career advice from people outside. What do you do?
Yeah, I go to him less for advice when I'm working and more for wisdom. And nice. I think one of the greatest things he's ever said to me was, you know, you can't bring everybody with you. And so as much as you want all of your friends to win at the same time, and as much as you want everybody to have the same hustle, you have to look out for yourself. And when you're able to get into that position, you're then able to bring your friends. But you can get easily distracted trying to win as a group. Sometimes people don't want the dream or want the hustle or want to do the work. And so he told me, he said, I see you want to make this a group thing. And right now you have to focus on yourself. And that was the greatest advice.
Oh, love it. He said, listen, solo dolo. Like, but it's true. Sometimes you have to move on your own sometimes. Like, you know, you love your friends, but you have to be an individual person. That's important. So where do you see yourself in the next few years? And, like, what's next for Skye? Because I'm sure there's a lot on the bucket list.
Yeah. For me, honestly, I just, you know, my first priority is enjoying the work that I do. I think, of course, we want to stay booked and busy, but it's like, if you're not having a good time, what's the point? So I want to work on projects that I love. But for me, I want to get into developing. I have so many ideas and films and shows in my head that now that I'm in a position to really start pitching and getting in these rooms, I would love to create my own content and hopefully do that in the next year or so.
Oh my gosh. Well, I look forward to seeing that because that's so amazing, developing content. Thank you, Sky. Like, I enjoyed this interview. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much. You're great, too. You on top of it.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That's an honor from you, honestly. And thank you, everyone, for watching Bold TV. Make sure you check us out on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, TikTok, and all of that good stuff. See you later.